Greetings. You must understand something. When you want to poison an animal, you do not simply set a bowl of poison in front of the animal. No, the animal will not care for the smell of the raw poison. You must mix some of the poison, enough to kill, in with the actual meat. So it is with Satan's lies. He does not serve them naked on a plate. He mixes his lies of poison with things that sound true. Surah 57:1. Whatever is in the heavens glorified God, and whatever is in and on the earth, and He is the Almighty, the Wise. Now I'm sure that reading this, using the word God instead of Allah, does not seem offensive. My gag reflex does begin to clench with the Islamitude of the wise, but this sounds very much like the meat of the message of the prophets. Psalm 150 verse 6, let everything that breathes sing praises to the Lord. Praise the Lord. Note, the Hebrew Tehallel Yah means praise to Yah. So you could read it this way. Psalms 156, let everything that breathes sing praises to Yahweh. Praise Yahweh. Psalms 96, 1 through 3, sing to Yahweh a new song. Sing to Yahweh all the earth. Sing to Yahweh, bless His name. Proclaim good tidings of His salvation from day to day. Tell of His glory among the nations, His wonderful deeds among all the peoples. 1 Chronicles 16:23-29. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Proclaim good tidings of His salvation from day to day. Tell of His glory among the nations, His wonderful deeds amongst all the peoples. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He also is to be feared above all gods. Isaiah 42:12. Let them give glory to Yahweh the Lord, and declare His praise in the coastlands. The problem comes when some demoniac replaces Yahweh with a demon called Allah. Then more than my gag reflex rises up. But you can see the 90% that is reasonable and appears to be sincere worship. The poison is the hook that steals Yahweh's glory and siphons it to Satan. Because the spirit that Mohammedism calls Allah is none other than Satan. Surah 57:2. He has sovereign control over the heavens and the earth. He gives life and brings death. He has power over all things. Again, such words seem sincere in their elevation of the deity they claim to extol. Until you recognize the Allah of this verse is equal parts life-giver and murderer, bringer of death. Make no mistake, Yahweh has the power of life and of death, but they are not equal parts of Yahweh's or His Son's heart. Deuteronomy 30:19, this day I call the heavens and the earth as witnesses against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessings and cursings. Now choose life, so that you and your children may live. If you are not smart enough, Yahweh gives you the right answer. John 10:10, the thief comes not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I, the Messiah, am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. John 11:25, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Notice, Jesus did not say, I am life and death. Hebrews 2:9, but we see him who for a little while was made lower than the angels, namely Jesus, crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. You see, O Muslim, this is the true Injil. This is the message from God. Not that God is equal parts life and death. Not some inconsistent, unpredictable, schizophrenic mishmash. 57:3, he is the first and the last, the outward and the inward. He has knowledge of all things. He is the outie and the innie. Allah is a belly button, and he is the most navel. And again, some of the words sound like sincerest exaltation, but the reflex of my gag is at the misappropriation. The one who is the first and last already calmed the sea. And when he said it's finished, it was done for you and me. And the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, said we were no more slaves of his, he would now call us his friend. John 15:15, no longer do I call you slaves. For the slave does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. Make no mistake, the bait of Satan's flowery poetic. But verses in Quran are only copies and pathetic. He it is who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, and he is firm in power. He knows that which goes deep down into the earth, and that which comes forth out of it, and that which comes down from the heaven, and that which goes up into it. And he is with you wherever you are, and Allah sees what you do. Muhammad tried and tried to cover every detail he could think of as a man, both up and down, in both directions. But then error would creep into his flowery prose, as he copied the Bible and would slip and include inconsistent text. He is with you wherever you are. Which sounds good and all, but Islam teaches Allah cannot enter his creation. And I think I know why Mohammedism must teach that Allah cannot enter his creation. How about you? Do you have an idea why Mohammedans must deny their Allah has this ability? If a Mohammedan ever admits that Allah can enter his creation, the whole jihad against Jesus, God with us, God in the earth, Yahweh announced by Prophet John, the Mohammedan destroys their objection to Jesus being the Son of God, and even being God himself in human form. I admit, I could not find a surah that says Allah cannot enter his creation. And I state this for academic clarity, not acceptance that the Allah of Islam is the God of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and Jesus, and all of the prophets of the Bible. He's not. But as you can see, there are many surah that appear to have similar sounding text to the Bible. And given the purpose of Islam to subvert and divert the message of God, that is an absolute necessary aspect, the foundation of the deception. Remember, 90% truth light and then 10% poison. And the dog will eat the meat and not notice the poison. And for far too many who think they eat pure, holy meat, they are wolfing down Satan's poison from the Quran and Islam. But do not be fooled by the meat laced with poison. Day after day, we see more and more of Islam's true heart killing Christians around the world. Day after day, we draw closer to the return of our Lord and Savior, the Son of God, the King of Kings. As Jesus suggested, recommended, encouraged, mentioned in Luke 21:36. Be watching at all times, therefore, and praying that you will be worthy to escape from these things which are going to occur, and to stand before the Son of Man. Do not be deceived, and do not partake yourself in the poison of deception. Love the truth, and submit to the one who is the truth. This much is certain. Either the rapture will happen, or it will not. But meditate on Luke 21:36. Be watching at all times, therefore, and praying that you will be worthy to escape from these things which are going to occur, and to stand before the Son of Man. There is a reason Jesus spoke this for our edification. I have begun praying these words as part of every prayer I find myself praying these days. Father, I pray that you will find us worthy to escape from these things which are going to happen and to stand before the Son of Man. I believe the time is short. Matthew 24:44. You also must be ready all the time, for the Son of Man will come when least expected. How about you? Did you expect him this summer? During the observed Rosh Hashanah? Do not let your guard down. Do not stop watching for the return of the bridegroom. The signs in the heavens have not changed their dates. And after an unfulfilled expectation, perhaps now you least expect him. For the Son of Man will come when least expected. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.